There, he kicked a couple up on Rod's backhand. He kicked one into his forehand, then blew some smoke down on him at set point, and he now leads two sets to love, Rod Laver, to start the third set. Laver has started serving in each set.
He's a champion, but Harry, you've seen him down. He's really down now.
He could make a recovery if the other fellow faulted. Rod has never beaten until
the final point is called against him.
He also has the uncanny knack of pulling off some big shots at the right time. Smoke City, 400 miles an hour. He just jumps on it.
Counting now is that right time.
I think you're right, Hop.
Yeah. 30-50.
Yesterday, I asked Connors if he preferred to hit the ball on the run. He said, I hit every ball on the run. He lunges into everything. He doesn't stand still for any stroke.
Serve an ace. That's the third ace for Laver. That's really the only bright spot in his serving. One double fault. He's had his service broken three times.
Service call correctly made by Hugh Stewart, who has just signed up to be the resident pro with Punch and Palace here at Caesars Palace.
Carry on the line.
Midnight
almost immediately. 40-30. Of course, the theory there, Vinny, is if you can't do anything else, throw it up in the air, at least make the guy beat you. Don't beat yourself.
Get it back.
And the Rocket, Rod Laver, holds serve.
With more action from Caesars Palace in Las Vegas, right after this word from your local station. The pattern so far in the match today, Laver has won the first game in each set. Connors has come back to win the second game in each set, and break Laver's serve in the third game in each of the first two sets. Laver, as usual now, has won the first game in the third set. Dick Martin, you saw 15 love, Connors.
Earlier, we have great tennis champions calling all these lines, and in my opinion, I don't think they've missed a call yet. I think it was a good decision to have these tennis people on the lines. They've done a very good job.
I have.
There's Billy Talbert, the director of the U.S. Open at Forest Hills, former Davis Cup captain, one of my very close personal friends, and I owe a great deal to him.
author of some fine tennis books.
That's right. And the U.S. Open, of course, will be seen here on CBS later this year.
Nice play, Tony.
Might get my check. 30-all, Connor serving. Second game of the third set.
The crowd kind of grown. I think they second-guessed that 40, first ball. 30.
Connors is just rushing Laver right off his feet. He's actually overpowering him on some plays and rushing him like that play.
Couldn't return the serve. That's twice he was able to
Vinny's mixed those services very well.
Well, the pattern is holding. Laver wins the first game. And now the pattern has been Connors to win the second game and then break Laver's serve in the third game. So we'll see if Rod's going to be hit by lightning for the third time.
And they're coming out with new balls. And being a patriotic gentleman, Vin, Harry Hopman is in favor of Rod Laver, hoping he'll win. But he's also superstitious. He said, don't talk about double faults when Rod's serving and don't talk about service breaks when Rod's serving.
That's not fair, Tony.
Interesting thing, you know how Laver prepared for this match, among other things, he would watch television, but looking into a mirror to see the reflection, so everyone seemed left-handed and in reverse. Maybe you right-handers should hold a mirror up to the screen, and then you'll know how the left-handers feel. Said, what are you talking about?
15 love.
Gus Lana, the umpire. The referee, Pancho Gonzalez, was just about up behind that chair and thought there was going to be some sort of dispute.
You could hear the umpire say the balls were changed in error. 15
love.
Pattern's about to change.
Looks that way. There it is. Laver holds the serve.
Done the fish fiction for sure.
Thank you very much. I have used up the commercial for left-handedness, and we'll get back to the game. Rod Laver leading 2-1. But more important, Jimmy Connors leading in set 6-4, 6-2.
By Rod Laver
on the forehand. I didn't expect that.
Evidently neither did Laver.
Sure.
Serving by Jimmy Connors, just plain overpowered
third set.
Well, there you have it. Connors won the first set 6-4, the second set 6-2. It's 2-2 in the third set, Laver to serve.
Seemed like he had a little bit of an inside slice on that backhand. That's really doing tricks with the ball.
You got to do that to win a point against Connors at this rate.
Oh, nice, Tony. Games are a 2-2.
That's the fourth ace for Rod Laver. And he gets an ovation as he comes back. So it is now Laver's 3-2.
Game.
Today's tennis, there's an NBA game, the Milwaukee Bucks and the Boston Celtics, right after the match. Laver leading 3-2. Connors has won two sets, 6-4, 6-2.
Let first serve.
That's a let first serve. Love.
I think Connors has smashed every one into Laver's forehand with the exception of one when he smashed from the other side. Seems that he prefers to sort of slice the overhead a little bit.
Does it beautifully too. In the first set, Connors was streaky. He won several games in a row. Same in the second. This third set, they were alternating, holding serve or on serve.
Ball.
That would be the third for Jimmy Connors. 15-15.
Harry?
Each double fault's come in the sixth game, strangely. No.
Rod shaking his head. It was easier few years ago. The slams came in 62 and 69. Talking about keeping temper, Laver said he gets much angrier now. He can hold it, but much angrier. Steps are steeper and the print gets smaller.
That's one of the really few unforced errors that Connors made in this match, particularly off the ground, the forehand and backhand. He has been magnificent. It's 30-all.
Couldn't you say particularly all around, Tony?
Yes, indeed. Very He's missed few. A couple of easy volleys, but very, very few of anything.
Ball.
30-all. Sixth game of the third set.
Rod might come in behind this return.
Mm-hmm. No, he stayed back.
He stayed back and Connors tried to go to him and went too long. And it's break point for Laver.
30, 40.
Laver has not broken Jimmy's serve.
Laver Lever had 4 break points on Connor's serve in the 4th game of the first set, and that's as close as he's gotten up to this point. Pick him up a little bit. There's no doubt it's an over 30 crowd here. Okay, so Rod Laver in the far court in the red shirt serving to Jimmy Connors in the near court.
Ball.
Tries to go down the line and misses. 15 love.
It's nice to know Connors is human, isn't it? 5 errors in the last 3 games.
Down the line, Connors goes cross court. Laver's there to bunt the backhand volley in the open court. We're back live. Laver's serving. First serves a fault. The crowd really reacting to the play of Laver at this stage.
30 love.
Anticipated perfectly by Laver. He figured he was going cross court, standing right there. 40 love. Laver needs one of these 3 points to go ahead 5-2.
Early in this set that he could come back, Finn, because I've seen him do it so often.
And really, Rod has continued to play fine tennis. Connors hit a patch where he became human and missed a couple of shots.
That's right. Jimmy has helped his comeback, hasn't he? Lost a little of the rhythm.
Connors serving a 2-5 in the third set.
Love. Connors holds out in front in this sequence. Laver will no doubt just more or less give him the point, knowing he can come back and win with his serve.
I don't think he'll give him the point. He'll try to hit winners just to save energy.
Right, and conserve it.
I think from this point you will see that Rod will probably go for a couple shots and certainly not expend much energy. Try to gear up and hold his serve.
Those of you who are waiting for basketball, remember, it's the Bucks and the Celtics right after tennis.
Shows you how much I know about it. He got in a rally with him, ran for a ball going down the line, stretched out.
That's the way it goes, Tony. Not the pool guy.
out over the baseline. That call was made by Tom Brown, another one of our great tennis names, calling the baseline. 40-15 for Connors. Trails 2-5 in the third set. Jimmy Connors with a good serve and very forceful volley. Hold serve.
Game, Mr. Connors.
Rod Laver will now be serving at 5-3.
Now, this is the chance for Rod to capture the set. This will be his best shot of the day.
Maybe.
$100,000 for the winner. And immediately after, Milwaukee Bucks and Boston Celtics. Let first serve.
I think Laver might try to go up the middle with this one. Connors is sliding over for the wide one.
Serves nice deep ball, half volleys.
15.
Connors goes down the line and Rod stabs for it. A very easy shot. And Connors comes right back to him and Laver with reflexes knocks it at Connors, who misses. Back live. 30-15.
30-15.
So Laver is 2 points away from winning the third set, getting back into this match.
Majority of sports writers, sportscasters figured that it would go at least four sets.
And double 40, set point.
15
for Rod Laver.
And the majority in the gallery wanted to go four sets at least.
Okay, Laver serves. Connor pulls a forehand down the line. Rod reaches out, does a good job of getting it back. Now, Jimmy misses a pretty easy ball here going cross court. Rod was looking for it down the line, but it's well out over the sideline and baseline. Sort of a bad error from Connor's standpoint. He has not made many of those. And there is the fighting Rod Laver, 36 years old. Many feel maybe the greatest player of all time. As you mentioned, Ben, the only player to win the Grand Slam twice. The fans are in his corner. Jimmy Connors has got him in a bit of a corner. He's down 2-1 to Jim Connors.
And the thing about Jimmy Connors, we should say for anybody who tuned in late, his behavior has been admirable. And that should be pointed out. And also, when he annihilated Rosewall, they tell me that he said it was an honor to be on the court with Ken Rosewall.
Very nice, wasn't that?
Yes, he's very good. He's a good kid. He's maybe a little self-disciplined, but he's a good kid.
He'll get it with experience, sure. For sure.
Okay, so the first time in the match, Jimmy Connors will start serving the start of a set.
Survived that third set.
I think he played an out ball. It was hit with some underspin. It was climbed, hit hard, but I think it was hit so hard that Rocket couldn't get his racket out of the way, so we went in to make the shot.
Well, he drilled that forehand passing shot. Connors couldn't have touched it unless he were another 10 feet tall.
confidence you do, Tony.
That's right. And it was a little bad luck on Connor's part. He went at a good volley, but hit the top of the net and slowed it down. Like a bullet, Laver makes the volley in an angled cross-court forehand volley for a winner. Triple break point.
How cool it was, Tony, with Jimmy almost down his throat.
Triple break point. First game of the fourth set. Beautiful serve by Connor.
15-40.
First game, fourth set. Still break point for Rod Laver. There's Charlton Heston, an absolute tennis nut.
Ball.
This can be a tough second serve to get in and get deep. A lot of pressure right now. Tennis match.
We'll be back with more action from Caesars Palace in Las Vegas right after this word from your local station.
I think the folks are going to be tardy.
They're going to be very late this morning, Vin.
They're watching it live.
So many rocket barrackers and all tennis enthusiasts will want to see Connors, too, because Jimmy was particularly popular out there.
He played so well, but lost to Newton.
The time in sports, the thing about momentum, but at this stage it looks as though the momentum has swung a little bit in Rod's favor. Connors is not playing as confidently, he's making more errors, and Rod is coming on strong.
And it seemed to change at the end of the fourth game in the third set. That was the turning point for Laver.
First of all, the way both these players play, they hit it so hard and so well, anything can change very quickly. The middle by Rod Laver puts him up 30-15.
Harry, I think you figured he'd do that about 30-40% of the time. About that.
I don't think Rod made the second shot that he wanted to make there. He's trying to go cross court with it and didn't get it over there at all and gave Connors a real good shot at the ball and
let him off, didn't he?
That's right, let him off the hook. Jimmy Connors has a point for a break to get even at one all in a fourth set. And the fans say, let's go. Break point. Out over the baseline. And Jimmy Connors breaks right back to level at one all in the fourth set.
That's the fourth time. Broken Laver serve, but first time since the second set.
That was a big game for both players. It was important for Connors to try to break, get right back in it. Important for Laver to keep the momentum.
Lockett had the chance to keep it going too, Tony.
Over on that deep forehand. He had a lot of action on that.
Trying to hit some looping balls, take a little speed off and make it bounce a little higher. There's the great Joe Louis.
The champ.
Yeah. The champ is right. In my opinion, the greatest heavyweight of all times. And even Howard Cosell's here. Connors lost to John Newcomb in the finals of the Australian Open recently. I thought one of the things that helped Nuke was the ability to change pace and change the spins and speeds a little bit. Rod is trying to do a little bit of that himself.
Terrific rally. Love. Connors comes 30. In down the line. Good deep shot, and what a backhand cross court. Holy Moses.
You know, it's not as if Connors made a short approach shot. He had it about 4 feet from the baseline.
And plenty of time to get in.
Again, Connors comes in on that short ball, goes up the line. Rod hits a backhand down the line, a volley cross court. Laver gets to it, and Connors blocks the ball back in the open court. Terrific tennis. Wow. Connors taking a little more time now between serves.
Seen a lot of movie miracles. He's looking at one here. You know, this is a Hollywood script.
It sure is. Connor is taking much more time now. I didn't bother Laver any.
Now, it would help him, if anything, I think, Tony.
Hit short balls that point. Mm-hmm. Rod really made a poor shot and a bad error. 40-30. One on the fourth set. Connors leads two sets to one. $100,000 from Caesar's Palace. Fine low return by Laver. They go to deuce.
They haven't been a deuce since the seventh game in the second set.
I would think that you lose a lot of effectiveness on that high shot indoors. You got a lot more going for you outside, don't you, Harry, on that shot?
Well, you can be more accurate inside.
But you have wind to help you and everything else outdoors.
But that didn't bother the event because Jimmy let it land, mm-hmm. You see.
You should never hit a defensive lob in the air because the other player can recover before you can touch it anyway. And the second time it comes down, it's coming down more slowly, so it's easier to time. Again, Connors has the ad. Talked to Pancho Segura, and one of the things they said was that if Laver was coming in on Connor's second serve, they would serve to his forehand instead of his backhand, yeah. Because Rod doesn't like to chip the forehand and come in like mm-hmm. he does the backhand. Jimmy has been doing that some this game. That's going to go out. It'll be out.
And it's break point for Rod Laver.
We've already had two breaks in this fourth set.
Out of two games.
Back to deuce. Good deep serve by Connors. Laver's forehand caught the tape. Doesn't look too worried, does he? An awful lot going on inside, though.
Seven times in the fourth game of the first set. That's when it looked like we were going to be here till next Thursday. Shot down the line, they go back to deuce again.
But he picked the overhead that time. He made a good deep defensive lob. And again, Connor smashed into Laver's forehand side, and Rod guessed right this time, was there and got back in the point. Jimmy said that he likes the high forehand volley. He really likes the power. He feels that really is his best volley of all.
Very confident there.
None of us like him down too low. Connors has not hit that serve well up the center in the ad court. He's missed quite a few of them.
Laver taking a very bad shot, loses the game.
sets to one.
Two games to one.
In progress, weren't we, the way this tennis match is going?
Tony, it was love 30. Rod had love 30 and then...
One break point. Okay, so we're still on serve.
Harry, do a little mind reading right now. What do you think M.O. is telling Rod?
Well, after that game, I would suggest that he's telling him to... He should try and go in there any time Jimmy's got a short ball, because Jimmy's coming in, Rod has made one beautiful backhand pass there, but he lost 3 points as Connors came in.
I agree, Harry. You have to really press these people. There's Pancho Segura, and many feel that he has one of the smartest tennis minds in the history of the game. He gets much of the credit for the progress Connors has made. That man is for Rod Laver, coming out on the court.
His mother said that Segura is the only professional she would trust Jimmy with, meaning she felt Segura would not change him at all and would just polish up the game she felt was set way back when he was 7.
Yep.
There's Donnie Carson, Clint Eastwood.
Both avid tennis players.
There we go.
They don't play quite as well as these two, though.
One of them is as quick with the tongue as he is as Rod to these two over the racket.
True. I started to say earlier that you have to take the short ball and go in regardless of how well someone hits passing shots or ground strokes. You have to continually insert pressure if you can on the other player.
Ball.
Backhand and didn't do it.
Short return by Laver when you're short approach shot, but it really was sort of effective as it turned out because it stayed low and Jimmy had to stretch, but he made a good shot by keeping his shot low and Rod missed a backhand volley.
A bad one then.
Serves, good return, good get, volley, and another terrific get. It's a lead ball, just drops over, and Rod touches the ball and just bunts it back over for a winner, and Connors knocks it right up into the ceiling. 30-15. 1-2 in the fourth set. Connors leads 2-1.
You noticed, Ben, in that second last point, your influence on the game, that girl who caught the ball, put the ball in her pocket.
Right.
We got some baseball fans here.
They usually throw them back at tennis.
First two sets, Laver lost. He won the first serve in each case, lost it the second time. He held on there and leveled it 2-2. If by chance we get the 6-6, we have the 12-point tiebreaker.
Or as Harry calls it, the 12-point heartbreaker.
A heartbreaker, but can be, can't it?
Okay, Connor serving with new balls.
Yes.
If there are any weaknesses to a two-handed shot, in my opinion, is stretching the player out real wide or getting it down low in front of the two-handed side. You just don't have the same control, balance, and reach that you do one-handed.
That was one obvious part of Labor's strategy going in, I'm sure.
Do that in this league.
No, the short shot by Laver really got him in trouble. Jimmy came in and Rod's backhand was much too high. That's why you come to the net. You put the onus on the other player. Say, beat me.
Volley up and adios.
Okay, now, in case some of the viewers don't recognize what happened, the linesman, Hugh Stewart, called a fault. Made a correction because he realized he'd made a mistake, so that means two serves. And the players would much prefer that than to have a stubborn linesman stick to a bad decision.
Well, he really carried that shot before he let it go.
13-15.
He might have played a little closer to the sideline than he wanted to, but he got away with it. 30-15. Much better depth by Lavery. Comes in on a pretty deep shot. Anticipated the cross-court return and hit the forehand volley for a winner. We're back live at 30-all. 2-all in the fourth set. Connors serving the near court. Lavery in the far court. Short second serve that time.
Dangerous. It was out.
It was out.
And Schroeder calling. 40-30.
And you know, I think Rod Laver played an out ball. I think Jimmy's ball was going to go long. Rod was in good shape. He was in perfect position. There's no need to take a chance. He figured he had the easy play, but he missed a volley. And it's 40-30.
The only vital point wasn't.
At this stage, they all get pretty vital, don't they, Hop?
Yeah, that's it.
Very hard to be a mass psychologist, but the crowd has suddenly tempered its enthusiasm again. Earlier, Connors got away quickly, came out of the chute to win the first two sets, 6-4, 6-2. Then suddenly, Labor began to come on, and that's when the crowd seemed to lift the pavilion, and Labor went on to win the third set, 6-3. But now, Connors has come back again in the fourth set to lead 3-2, and the crowd seems, at least for the moment, a little quieter, and it's getting hotter by the minute in the pavilion.
Then,
Boston leading Milwaukee 18-12 in the first period for the big round ball Buffs. Remember, that game will follow us just as Andy Williams follows tennis.
Ben, you mentioned earlier that it was an over 30 crowd. Actually, I think it's more like it was slightly anti-Connors because of all the publicity.
Right.
But this sort of thing would change because Jimmy's so good.
That's Mary Labor wearing that very colorful hat. Mary and Rod, along with their young son, Ricky, who is 5 and a half, but they had to send Ricky home. They said the pressure was getting too much and the match was getting to him, so they sent him home.
15 love.
That was a very polite way of saying they got rid of the kids.
That was a good second serve by Lavery. He served tight into Connor's one-hander. Jimmy pulled it wide.
Connors was anticipating all guns firing if he went under on that one.
30 love.
30 love.
Labor levels at 3-all in
game,
the fourth
Mr.
set.
Labor. Games are 3-all, fourth set.
Somebody lets out a holler, and that summed up the enthusiasm of the crowd. It sounded like a cowboy hollering on the last roundup.
And in case you joined us late, Jimmy Connors won the first set 6-4. He broke serve twice to win the second 6-2. Rod Laver came back to win the third 6-3, and we're 3-all in the fourth set with Jimmy Connors to serve.
And there'll probably be a couple of those yippies on the old Laver cattle station.
I guess so.
Here he comes. And Connors points the finger and says, oh, no, you don't. You're not going to come in and get me.